Welcome back, friends. I have done some updates part of billing system. I have done some code implementation, which is user registration with different type of customers. That is, user can register as an employee, user can register as a customer, user can register as a vendor. These three part I have done. I'll going to explain those things in few minutes. Before that, I want to tell what is our billing system architecture. This is very simple architecture only. It does not have any complex. It's a very simple architecture. Normally, all Spring Boot application use this architecture. Okay. It has a presentation layer, service layer, DAO layer. Okay. This DAO layer connect to database. Presentation layer. Presentation layer is only our controller class. That is, the presentation layer contains all web service implementation, web service method implementation. This presentation layer handle only request, response and a header. Those part only handle the presentation layer. It does not have any business logic. It can have logic, but that logic must be related to request, response, header. That logic must be related to client side, not a backend side. Let's go into the controller. We'll check what is the presentation layer in our source code. See here, there is a one package called controller. Under this package, I have created three controller class. The test controller is a dummy one. For testing purpose, I have created. I will go and remove that later. There is a user private controller, user public controller. I have done some implementation in user public controller. User private controller is nothing. When you look at this user public controller, there is a one method called save user. This save user is a post mapping. Post mapping, that is, I want to create something through this controller method. This endpoint can be accessed by your server name api/public/user. When you use this user URL, when you use this URL, that is, http://localhost/9090/9091/ if you use post method in the client side, if you use this URL, then if you use post method in this client side, this particular method get invoked. Okay, see here, client have to send a request part of this request body. Whatever request sending client, that client information, that request information come here. After processing this request, the final response come as response entity. So when you look at very high level in this method, I am handling only request related logic and the response related logic. That's it. This taking some request and sending the response. That's it. Nothing is in this method. So the presentation layer should handle only request and response. As needed, we can handle header. That's what I am doing here. Okay. Why I have created two controller class for user. User private controller, user public controller. If any REST web services accessible by only particular user, that is accessible by authorized user, those REST service implementation, I want to keep it inside a user private controller. If any REST web services implementation, that is REST web service implementation method accessible by everybody in the world, those web service implementation, I want to keep inside a user public controller. This is just standard. This is just a standard I am following. Nothing technically. Okay. In the user public controller, I have auto wired one class called register service, registration service. Okay. If you go inside a registration service, I have some bunch of logic. This logic registering three different of users. One is customer, one is employee, another one is vendor. Inside a registration service, I have auto-add another service called a billing base service. Billing base service. When you go into the architecture diagram, the service layer, I am saying that two kinds of service. One service take care of business logic, another service take care of CRUD operation, DB CRUD operation, that is adding a data, removing a data, updating a data, then fetching a data. This CRUD operation taken care by one service, that is that service always talk to DAO layer for CRUD operation. One service handle only business logic. The registration service handling the business logic. The registration service handling the business logic, it's registering three type of customer, three type of users based on the request type. Okay. In the registration service, I have declared another service called billing based service. When you go inside a billing based service, it has generic code. It has only very generic code. Using generics, I have implemented this class. Here you can say save method, find all method, find by ID, delete by ID, delete. In the parameters, there are some parameter types. It's a more generic T type. That is, this particular T can accept any type of classes. In the save T entity, this particular save method can accept any type of entity. For example, there is an entity package. In this entity package, there are 16 entity object. This 16 entity object accepted by this particular save method. So this billing based service is a very generic implementation. This used for CRUD operation for all entity object defined here. I don't want to create separate service method for each entity object. Okay. These are only one service class handle CRUD operation. I am doing that CRUD operation using JPA repository interface from the JPA API. Okay. This is from JPA. From the JPA, I am using one JPA repository interface. Through this interface, I am calling the save method. When you see here, save method here, I am calling repository.save, I am passing an entity method. Sorry, I am passing an entity object. This save return one entity object. That entity object could be address, could be biller, it could be tax, anything. That save return the form of base object. Base object is a parent class of this particular entity classes. So it will return base object in my service class. I will going to convert that particular base object, whatever object I need. I will going to explain more detailly this code so that you will understand very clearly. Go back to the public controller. This is the request body. This request body coming from client side. Let me open the Postman. See here, localhost 9091 API public user. I'm using post method. In the user public controller, API public user, API public user, the port number I mentioned in YAML file, application YAML file 9091. Okay, so localhost 9091 API public user, I'm using post method. When you do that, it will call this particular method. Okay. When I click send button, I am passing this request body. This is a request body I am sending to this endpoint. See here, first name, middle name, last name, mobile number, email ID, flow type. Flow type will tell what type of user you will going to register. If you say customer, this user registration will do the customer registration. If you do employee, if you pass here as an employee, it is for employee registration. If you pass here as a vendor, it is for vendor registration. This request information is equivalent to user ETO. This request information equivalent to user ETO. Whatever attribute I am using here, that attribute I am using here. See here. First name, middle name, last name, mobile name, flow type, email ID. I am using entire thing here. And apart from that, there is an address list. See your address list. Inside address list, I have an address object. That's address, that is address object nothing but address DTO. That is address object nothing but address DTO. Okay. Then roles. Roles nothing but roles DTO. When you look at inside roles DTO, there's a name and description. Role name and description. See here, role name and description. Okay. So this particular JSON request representation of user DTO. This JSON request representation of user DTO. Whenever user send, click the send button. Whenever user send, click button. By using this URL, by using post method, automatically this particular method get invoke. Since this request is representation of user DTO, all this attribute automatically mapped into this user DTO. Since I mentioned request body, this user DTO mapped to this particular JSON. Spring Boot will do that magic automatically behind the scene. Spring Boot receive this request. The Spring Boot convert this request as a user DTO. Okay. Now that user DTO I am passing as a parameter inside a do registration method, which is coming from registration service. Okay. When you go here inside registration service, this parameter base DTO. This parameter is a base DTO. If you see here user DTO, the user DTO coming from base DTO only. That is, user DTO is a child class of base DTO. So I can pass any child class inside a do registration. Actually, I am passing here user DTO here. I am taking flow type. If the flow type is employee, then I am registering employee. If the flow type is customer, I am registering customer. If the flow type is vendor, I am registering vendor. When I explain this code to you, I realize that we don't have to pass base DTO here. Previously, I was using base DTO as a parameter. Now, I changed it to user DTO. The reason is this particular method handled only user registration so that I can pass user DTO directly. When you look at this controller, the user DTO coming as a request body. User DTO coming as a request body. So that I can pass this user DTO object directly to do registration method. In the user DTO, there is one attribute called flow type. Based on this attribute value, this method decide do we need to employee registration or customer registration or vendor registration. In the JSON request, you can see flow type equal to employee. That meaning I want to do employee registration. If you pass vendor, I want to do vendor registration. In the line number 25, this particular method convert user DTO to user entity object. This line number 25 convert user DTO to user entity object. Okay, I don't want to use this user DTO in DAO layer. I want to use user DTO only presentation side. I want to use user entity object only in DAO layer. I don't want to use this user entity as a request body. That is the reason I am using this mapper framework. This is the map struct. I am implementing this particular code through map struct framework. Using that map struct framework, we can convert one object value to another object. In this case, I am converting user native object value to user entity object. Please take a look the video which I linked in this video description that clearly explains how to work with MapStruct, how to convert one object to another object. I don't want to explain part of this video. Please watch that video for better understanding about MapStruct. Okay. After converting as a user object, user entity object, if flow type variable contain employee of employee value, they come to here. It's come to if block, populating the employee object, populating the employee object. Finally, I'm passing that employee object to building service dot save. This building base service is generic class to handle CRUD operation. This building base service handle CRUD operation for all entity we created in this application. For here we have created 16 entity object. This building base services, one building base service is enough to handle CRUD operation for all entity object. That is a magic of this building base services. I don't want to create a separate service class for each entity object to perform CRUD operation. When you go inside this method, serve method, it accept T, that is class type. Any class type I can pass. I can pass your employee, I can pass your order, I can pass your product. Any entity object I can pass here. That entity object accepted by serve method, which is coming from repository interface. Repository interface is coming from JPA, JPA API. Okay, now this JPA API save this entity to in our database. After successful saving, this save method return that new record in the form of the entity object. Let's say I am passing employee reference here, that employee new record returned by this save method. Okay, now that employee object I am converting as a base object and assigning to here, and assigned to here. This base object now contains employee object with ID, with primary key. Okay, now I want to send this response to my client. That is, that client can be React, the client can be Angular. In our case, our client is Postman. Okay, now I want to send this employee information, employee record, as a JSON response to in my client side. For that, I want to convert this base object as a D2O class. Now this base object contains employee reference, right? So that I am converting this base object to employee entity object and passing to my MapStruct framework. Employee mapper dot instance employee to DTO. That is, convert this employee object to employee DTO. This particular method convert employee entity object to employee DTO and assign to employee DTO object. Then I am passing this employee DTO with response data function. This with response data is a static function coming from response message class. Go inside the response message class. We'll check the structure of response message class. Again, this response message class implemented using generics. Okay, this response message I can pass any class type. I can pass any class type. In our case, we are passing employee DTO. So this employee DTO come to here. This employee DTO come to here. Then string message. What I am saying in the string message, I am saying employee created successfully. Then message type, I am saying message. If any error, I want to say some error message. I want to say message type as a error. Now with response data I am passing employee data, employee DTO, then one message, then message type that come to here, that come to here. Now I am passing this information, my constructor argument of response message, my constructor argument of response message. But this constructor I never defined in this class. How this constructor I am using here, how this constructor I'm using here without defining the constructor. The magic done by Lombak library. When you look at here, I'm using at all or constructor, at all or constructor. Through this annotation, Lombak create one constructor. In that constructor, it will take all this member as an argument. All this member as an argument. That is called as all or constructor. That is generate constructor. Okay. So this is the constructor created by all or constructor. Okay. Since we are using all or constructor, we don't have to create manually. I'll go and remove this. That is the reason only I am able to use this constructor here. Whenever call with response data, passing the proper argument. In our case, I am passing employee D2Y here. I am passing some message. I am passing some message type. That value come here. This class type I am passing employee D2O. Now employee D2O come here. Message come here. Message type come here. Now my response message holding employee DTO with message and a message type. That value I am returning here. That value I am returning here. This do registration method return that particular response message. This do registration called in user controller. Now this do registration return response message. That response message contain employee DTO, one message information, then message type, that value returned in our Postman client. Okay. This response message, I can use response class for all type of REST services. I don't have to change. I can use the same for all REST endpoint which I am going to implement. Today I am using save user. Tomorrow I am going to create a new REST endpoint which for creating order, which for creating a bill. Okay, for those REST endpoint, I can use the same response. The reason is I'm using a generic class type. The generic class type can accept any classes. Any classes that could be order, that could be a product, that could be stock. Okay, anything it can accept, so that I can use this response message class as a response type for all type of REST service implementation. I hope you understand whatever I explained. If not, please comment me. Definitely, I will go into reply. See here, in the request body, I am passing one D2O class. Then I am calling a service method. Then I am calling a service method. That service method doing the business logic. After doing the business logic, I am calling a billing based service. That billing based service do the crude operation that will talk to repository object. Repository object talk to DAO to store in the database. Okay, this is the flow I will going to use. The same flow I will going to use all type of entity object. For example, I want to store product. I want to store stock. I want to store category. For all those flow, I'll going to use the same flow which I explained you. Okay, I don't have to explain again and again. Please take this flow as a reference for future implementation. Okay, for example, if I implement purchase order, if I implement a purchase order, I'll going to use the same flow. So I don't want to explain that. Okay. Please check a MapStruct video and the Lombak video. All are given in the description link, YouTube description link. Please take a look at Lombak as well as MapStruct. That is very, very important. We need to understand that. Now I'll go to show the demo. This is my MySQL workbench. There are some values. I'll going to remove that. This roles, it has some values, no values. Okay, I removed all the rows. Now I'll going to start the server. Run. Now I'm going to create a three type of users. Server is started now. Go to Postman. Already I have a JSON request. See, now I'm going to change only this name. Suresh underscore employee. This employee registration, I am changing the first name and the float type is employee. So, this is for employee registration. This is a old record response. Okay. See here, this is a 29 ID. When I click send, I will going to clear this log. See, Suresh employee, test Stalin, full name. I previously the old record is 29, now it says 30. That meaning the record created successfully. The status is 201 created. In the console, see here, inserting user table, inserting address table, inserting role table, inserting employee table, inserting user role table. Since we are using float type equal to employee, it inserting the employee table. Let's see the database now. Employee table, it has a record, user ID 39. User record, user ID is a 39, that user mapped to this employee record. Then address, where is address? Yeah, there is address, already there are already some record, I have not deleted, I think. See, 39. This user is a, ID is a 39. For the 39, there is a new record created. This is a new record created. So 39. When you check log, there is an address also inserted here. For 39, record generated. Then role. Role also generated. Then user role. It's a mapping table. User ID is a 39, role ID is a 30. Role ID is a 38. User ID is a 39, that mapping created here. User ID 39, user role ID 38. So, employee flow successfully working, so properly working. Now we are going to check customer flow. Going to see customer, change flow type customer. Then I am going to say K7 customer. Customer. I'll going to say test customer. Now I'll going to send the request. Before that, I'll clear this. When you see the response, see K7 customer test Stalin. The same thing will come here. User also created. Check that log. User table inserted, address table inserted, role table inserted. Now customer table inserted. Since we are passing flow type customer, this is a customer registration, customer type inserted. Then user role inserted. See user. 40 inserted. When you check employee, you don't see that record. It has only customer employee record. When you check customer, it has a customer record. User ID is a 40. User ID is a 40. Like that, address table get inserted. 40th record. 40. Then role table. Then user role. Okay. The role table, there is one bug. I will explain that in next video. What is that bug? How to fix it? Okay. But role table also inserting, user role also inserting. Now for the customer, see your customer ID is 40. For that role ID is a 39. Now we're going to register vendor. customer dot vendor. And I'll go to click send. See Kumar vendor test vend ved Stalin. It's created. When you check the database here, user table inserted, address table inserted, role table inserted. Oh, sorry, I not changed here vendor. We need to change vendor, right? Since it's customer, again it inserted in customer table. See, we need to change flow type vendor. Now we'll go and check again. I'll clear this. I changed to vendor flow type. Now instead of Kumar, I'll say Karthik. Then test vet one. Flow type is a vendor. See Karthik vendor test VD1 Stalin is created. When I check customer table, there is no record for that new one. Employee table, there is no record. Now vendor table, there will be a new record created. See whatever the response is there, that response value also here. Then user table, we have a new record called vendor records of 42. See here, so 42. Also address table, you can see 42. User ID 42. So now the user registration working perfectly. There are some few issue I noticed that is the role. I will explain the next video what is the issue. I'll fix that. Then otherwise it's not blocking, it's working fine. The next video I will come up with exception handling and validation framework, then logging framework integration. Then these three things we need to implement. After implementing these three things, we'll going to focus on building system functionality, real functionality. Okay, I have committed all the files in building system repo. Please take it and try to set up in your local machine. And also I created a sample request which I used in Postman. Whatever request I used here, I have added in this part of source code in the main resource folder. Under resource folder, created JSON request. In the JSON request folder, I created one file called user.json. Use this for your testing purpose. Whatever I explained you now, those things I created as an article in medium.com. Go and check here if you are not able to follow in my video. Okay, see here I given a Mapstack configuration, the Lambda configuration, building system architecture. Please follow me in this medium.com. It will be a great helpful for me. Also, please share this video. Please share this video to your colleagues and friends. Until then, bye bye from Suresh.